the instrumentals that you heard were so beautiful.
It was all just a journey.
It felt like I was meditating.
I think they're gonna be shocked.
They were something like gospel songs, but with a totally different musical format.
It's a really, really deep, deep album.
It was absolutely personal.
I started to cry, so did she.
Just the mainstream radio is just not ready to hear a message like this, music like this.
But if you are open and you like music, then it's not about hits.
To just hear one song totally would take away from what he's trying to say.
When you read a book, you don't want to just read a chapter. You want to read the entire book.
You need to listen to it from beginning to end.
This is a great work of art.
The album was basically going through a spiritual journey of a person.
And I loved it, and I don't care if they play on the radio or not.
He's just planting a seed.
And the scenes play out in one's mind, one's heart, one's soul.
He's giving us something to think about, something to inspire.
If you don't want to listen, oh well, but those of us that do, we're going to be out there pumping it up, you know?
Love it or hate it, you know, it's out there, it's coming out.
And the old him to me is totally, it's gone.
I'm hearing a message, and that message is positive, and that message is clear.
It was fantastic.
I loved it.
I want my copy.
I'm blown away. I think we'll be talking about this album maybe 10 or 20 years down the road.
Just like the sun, the rainbow children rise.
Do the people even know what they want if they never hear what they need? Do the people even know what they want if they never hear what they need? Do the people even know what they want if they never hear what they need? Do the people even know what they want if they never hear what they need?
Why you giving people what they want when you ought to give them what they need?
Jukebox with a heartbeat. Tryna run a game, oh man. Jukebox with a heartbeat. If it's popular, it ain't free. Jukebox with a heartbeat. Tune it all out, we'll see. Do the people even know what they want if they never hear what they need?
Are you giving people what they want when you ought to give them what they need?
Bye.
because a bay girl baby is hot.
Ain't no girl like a bay girl,
because a bay girl baby is hot.
Yo, if I don't open your door, or slide your chair, or pretend to listen, yo, when I really don't care. What if you trip? Who's gotta step in? Yo, Charlie can't save you, he's made pretend. Free spirited bay girl, let me tell you something about the real world. There is none, I would lay a lawn chair right there in the middle of the dance floor.
Hunter's point.
Get my mail here, have a garage sale here with little devious and putting little toys in my ear.
Next city, can't find where I was. Say, he back in the bay, he done fell in love. 5 foot six, Carmel or something, and all the one place his blood was rushed.
I try to be responsible, but it's hard with you, bae girl. I said I try to be responsible, but it's hard with you, bae girl.
Meet me at the hickory pit.
Yo, Stella, if you think I'm afraid of you. Grace, if you so much as think I came do to do. Girl, if you dream I came to jerk around, you better wake up and release it.
Dearly beloved, we have gathered here today to get through this thing called life. And if the elevator tries to bring you down, go crazy, put your hands. Take a look around, at least you got friends. Come on, lady, friendly word. Big dumb bump, dropped it on the floor. Was all I heard. Gonna let the elevator wreck us now. Let's go crazy, let's get nuts.
Did you come to party? People, did you comes to a party. They say, do that ish, do that ish, do it. They do that ish, do that ish, do it. Every Friday night I call your ass up on the phone. Deeper voice answers, says you're not at home. If you think that I'm a fool, we'll go for any line. Honey, put down all your money, you win every time. Oh, I love the way you walk. I love the way you talk. I love the way you kiss. New York, you know I can't resist. Stoned on my woman, played it off like it was a joke. Stealing all my money, baby, keep you by my side. Leading it till I'm broke. Hell, if I know I let her drive my car, don't I know that walking won't get me very far? Don't I know that crying over her is just in vain? All the things I lose don't add up to half the shit I gain. New York!
like a train.
True.
don't you know I love, love my dirty little cave?
Hello? Hey! What are you doing?
No, I'm just sitting here. Yeah, with a script. No, it's this new offer that I just got. Yeah. I know, it's good, but... yeah, you know what it is? It's just out of nowhere on page 62, there's suddenly this love scene, and it's just, you know, the girl tears off her clothes in wild abandonment. It's funny how the guys never have to do that. I mean, he's apparently also crazy in love, but he's dressed. So, I don't know what I'm gonna do about it. You sound weird though, what's wrong? Well, what? What? Whoa, go back one? They offered you what? Yeah? Yeah, but that means... that means you're gonna be naked in this. What do you mean a tasteful spread? That's a pun in right there. That sounds horrible! Wait, okay, calm down here. Okay, wait, so let me get this straight. They offered you to do, what, 6 pages in this men's magazine, naked. And you're thinking about it. Okay. Well, forget the money for a second, right? Because it's never about the money. Did you talk to your parents about this? Well, what did your mom say? What do you mean she wasn't sure? Okay. That's a little weird because I think if I was a mom, I would not be very happy with this. No, I wouldn't. It's different. No, if it was my daughter, I would tell her not to do it. I would ask her to have a little more self-esteem and believe in herself. I mean, Chloe, no, just, okay, listen. What is this magazine for? Think about it. It's going to be selling in every truck store stop in America to, you know, every guy who has $5, basically. Everyone who has $5 can see you naked. Great. It's not for everyone, you know? It should be for someone you love. I'm sorry if that's old-fashioned. Actually, you know what? Do you know that Suzanne did this too? Yeah, she just did it. Uh-huh. Why are you surprised? Oh, I see. Okay, so... Wait, you are surprised that she did it because you wouldn't expect this of her? I think you should think about what you just said. See? Now you've changed your whole perception about her. Well, guess what? She's not doing it. Do you know... No. Do you know the George Bernard Shaw story? I don't know if he made it up or not, but it's basically a great story. He said that he went to this bar one night, and there was this beautiful woman sitting there. And he walked up to her and said, "Look, I don't want to disturb you, but would you go up to my room with me for $10,000? And she said, "Okay." And so he gave her a dollar and said, "Let's go." And she turned to him and she got really mad and she said, "What do you think I am?" And he said, "Well, we already know what you are. We are just discussing the price. Call me tomorrow."